7% higher quarter-on-quarter, and profits were also have about 6.5-7%. Let's hear it out from the management then on what worked for them this quarter.
See, clearly what's been satisfying this quarter is that all our vertical groups have done extremely well. BFSI grew 10.5% quarter-on-quarter. Retail consumer products grew 6.5%. High-tech, which has been a laggard, grew 2%. And travel and hospitality grew 1.8%. So it is a well-rounded growth from all our vertical segments. Beyond that, on the service lines, infrastructure grew 6.4% quarter-on-quarter. Digital, which has been a service area which we've been putting investments and efforts on, grew 12.7% quarter-on-quarter. So the service lines have also significantly contributed to the growth. On geographies, US again had a great quarter, 9% quarter-on-quarter growth. Europe degrew 3.1%, but that's also based on the currency impact. So if you look on a constant currency basis, the degrowth is just about 1.5%. We do feel that the funnel in Europe and the efforts which are putting in will help us get Europe back to a growth mode. So overall, if you look at the solid growth this quarter, it's been a very well-rounded growth.
Also, I'd want to come to you, Jagan. With your revamped M&A team, you've loosened the purse strings really by $70 million. You've made two strategic acquisitions. While you take us through the financials of these two companies, can you also tell us how will this bolster growth for Mindtree?
Actually, these two acquisitions are in two critical areas for us. Actually, if you see, digital is actually system of engagement and system of document. So we have invested in both now. The Relational Solutions Inc. is actually in system of engagement, and Bluefin is in system of document for us. So this is actually going to help us focus both on the front end as well as in the back end of our supply chain for our customers in digital journey.
I'd want to come to you, James, in terms of what Bluefin brings really to table in terms of revenue contribution. Can you take us through some information on that bit?
So the revenues, last trailing month's revenues were, I think, £28 million, something like that. I think the big thing for us, though, is that we have a great set of marquee clients of big global brands that we do a lot of work with, but there's huge opportunity because of the scale that we now get. And our clients have been saying to me for a while, they really want to have this global scale so that we can not only expand the nature of the projects that we do, but also then take on the support and the ongoing maintenance of those projects and engage with them more broadly in the digital space.
Interesting. Also, KK, I'd want to come back to you on how does deal pipeline really look for FY16?
See, clearly we are seeing the demand environment being very strong in the segments in which we are in, which is retail, consumer products, high tech, travel, hospitality, and BFSI. There is significant amount of investments going, like Jagan said, on the systems of engagement on the front end, particularly discretionary spends like digital. So if we look at Mindtree's own funnel, in the last 90 days, our funnel is showing almost a 25% quarter-on-quarter increase. The funnel for digital alone is little over 100 million. Beyond that, what we have also seen is the average value of deals in digital is also increasing. In the last quarter, that's increased by about 15%. We also shared that last quarter, we signed contracts for 208 million. Of which 160 million is on existing customers and the rest on new customers. So with strong contract closures, with the pipeline being very strong and the demand environment being healthy, we are very certain that quarter two growth will be definitely better than quarter one growth. Quarter one growth was 5.2% constant currency. We believe it will be better than that. For FY16, we believe we'll be able to beat the NASSCOM estimates of 12-14%. So overall, we are very, very confident of the demand environment.
Ajikan, I want to come to you. The profit numbers have been a little flat on a year-on-year basis. Your margins have taken a hit as well, 190 basis points there. So can you tell us, with the wage hike really to also hit the quarter two, when will the margins really come under control? You know, what steps will Mindtree take to in this regard?
I just first want to clarify on quarter one margin. Our quarter one margin was basically because of visa fees. This is actually a conscious effort from our side to apply for more visas to prepare ourselves to capture or leverage on the revenue momentum that is coming up at present. On coming back to quarter two profitability, we expect it to be better than quarter one. However, we have a headwind of salary increase. Around 450 campus minds are going to join Mindtree. So these two will be the headwinds. But considering the revenue momentum and we don't have a visa piece in quarter two, we feel our profitability will be slightly better than the quarter one. And year-on-year basis, me and KK have commented earlier also, we are continuing our investments on digital and infrastructure, which is going to support our growth. So because of our investments, we feel there will be some impact on our profitability compared year-on-year basis.
Also, KK, I will definitely come to you on the NASSCOM. Mindtree has always been very bullish in beating the NASSCOM guidance you have. Just trying to know, where are you getting this confidence from? Is it largely because a few client issues that you had in Q4 have been sorted out, or is it because of the robust deal pipeline that you see from here?
See, clearly, you're absolutely right. When we started the year, we did mention that in two of our key clients, we do have soft demand issues, one which will get solved, which is true. In quarter one, the client where the decision was shifted has come back to growth. And if you see our others category, that has declined by about 33% year on year, which is really reflective of the client who is going through some soft demand issues. While those are the only demand related issues which you're facing, the demand pipeline is very, very healthy. Like I shared with you, our digital services demand is very good, grew 12.7% quarter on quarter, and at the end of this quarter, digital is 35% of our revenues, and we continue to see strong momentum on that. Clearly, North America still continues to see strong growth momentum. For five quarters, they've demonstrated good quarter-on-quarter growth, and we anticipate that to continue. Europe currency impact was there. Clearly, we are putting in a lot of efforts to bring Europe back to the growth. So half year two, you'll see Europe coming back to a moderate growth target.
Okay, that's a Mindtree management, and the stock has been fairly active.